एवरीवन, दिस इज़ योर बायोलॉजी क्लास. आई एम योर टीचर सीमा अत्रेजा. स्टूडेंट, इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टडी हाउ इज द डाइजेस्टेड न्यूट्रिएंट्स एब्जॉर्ब्ड इन अवर बॉडी. इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट स्टेप ऑफ डाइजेशन एंड एब्जॉर्प्शन, दैट इज एसिमिलेशन. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय एसिमिलेशन? एसिमिलेशन मीन्स यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ एब्जॉर्ब्ड फूड. First, we will discuss about monosaccharides. Main monosaccharide produced here is glucose. Along with glucose, small amount of fructose and galactose also produced. These monosaccharides through the hepatic portal vein reach to liver. Here glucose is utilized by the cell to produce energy. In the form of ATP, and wherever energy is used, is utilized by the body. Extra amount of glucose is converted into glycogen. What is glycogen? It is the reserve food in our body and is stored at two places. It is stored in liver as well as in muscles. Or whenever glucose is required, these reserve food, that is glycogen, is further converted into the glucose. Next, we will discuss about the amino acids. Amino acids also reach to liver through hepatic portal vein inside the liver. Required amino acid are converted into protein . This protein is utilized in the formation of cell membrane. It may be used as an enzyme in our body. Protein ki formation ho jati hai required amino acid se, and some of the protein is utilized in the formation of cell membrane, or it may be utilized in the form of enzymes. Some of the protein is utilized in the formation of protoplasm. Next, unwanted amino acids undergo the process of deamination. Deamination, they are converted into urea and then excreted out as urine from the body. Some of the amino acids deaminates एंड दे आर कन्वर्टेड इनटू ग्लूकोज. दिस इज द प्रोसेस वेयर ग्लूकोज आर प्रोड्यूस्ड नॉट फ्रॉम द पॉलीसेक्राइड्स बट अदर देन द कार्बोहाइड्रेट. द सोर्स ऑफ ग्लूकोज इज अदर देन कार्बोहाइड्रेट. द प्रोसेस इज नोन एज द ग्लूकोनियोजेनेसिस. सो सम ऑफ द एमिनो एसिड्स दे डीएमिनेट्स देयर एमिनो ग्रुप रिमूव्ड एंड दे आर कन्वर्टेड इन टू द ग्लूकोज. अनवॉन्टेड और टॉक्सिक एमिनो एसिड विच आर नॉट रिक्वायर्ड इन द बॉडी दे डीएमिनेट एंड कन्वर्टेड इन टू यूरिया. यूरिया इज द लेस टॉक्सिक फॉर्म इन अवर बॉडी. लेटर ऑन यूरिया इज ऑल्सो एक्सक्रीटेड आउट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ यूरिन. नेक्स्ट द प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ द फैटी एसिड्स हाउ दे आर यूटिलाइज. Fat is also reached to liver through hepatic portal vein. It is utilized in the formation of cell membrane, as in cell membrane, bilipid layer is there and phospholipids are there. So it is utilized in the formation of cell membrane. Some of the fat is stored into the adipose tissue. Fat stored in the body in the form of adipose tissue. And a fat layer is also deposited around vital organ of our body. This is the fate of the substances produced in our body. Fat through the hepatic portal vein reached to the liver. It is utilized in the formation of the cell membrane. It may be stored in the adipose tissue and a fat layer may be deposited around the vital organ of the body. Amino acids through the hepatic portal vein, they reach to the liver. Required amino acid converted into protein. Protein is utilized in the formation of cell membrane. It may be used as an enzyme and protein is also used in the formation of the protoplasm. Toxic amino acids which are not required to the body, they deaminate and convert it into urea. This urea is excreted out in the form of urine from the body. Some of the amino acids, they deaminate and convert it into glucose. This is the process known as the gluconeogenesis. Here the glucose is synthesized other source. They are not synthesized from the carbohydrate, but other source of glucose is here, that amino acid converted into glucose. The process is known as gluconeogenesis. What is the fate of monosaccharides? Monosaccharides also through hepatic portal vein reach to the liver. Some of the glucose is utilized by the cell to generate energy for various working of the body, and some of the glucose is converted into glycogen. Glycogen is the stored food in our body and is stored at two places, in the liver as well as in muscles. And whenever the glucose is further required in the body and glucose is not available, then this reserve glycogen is converted back into the glucose and utilized by our body. So this is the process of assimilation takes place in our body. Next process is the egestion. What is egestion? After absorption of the food material into ileum and jejunum part of the small intestine, some food still left in the small intestine and not absorbed. that is the undigested waste remain there. These undigested waste are eliminated from the body. So elimination of undigested waste through anus is known as egestion. Chyle produced in the small intestine. What is chyle? Completely digested alkaline food in the small intestine is known as the chyle. From duodenum, this chyle enter into the jejunum and ileum part of the small intestine, where digested food material is absorbed, and which is not absorbed, that enter from small intestine into the large intestine, and they remain in the colon part of the large intestine. This is known as the undigested food. From the undigested food, water and some mineral ions are absorbed into the colon area, and after absorption of the water and mineral salts, these undigested waste are solidified, and now we called it as the feces. These feces from large intestine reach into the rectum. Rectum, when receive these feces from the large intestine or colon part of the large intestine, it dilates. When it dilates, a urge is created to defecate the feces, and these feces are expelled out through the anus. The process is known as the egestion. So removal of undigested waste through anus is known as the egestion. Undigested waste from small intestine enter into the colon part of the large intestine. What is the function of colon? Colon solidify the undigested waste and convert them into feces. Inside the colon, water and mineral salts absorbed from the undigested waste. So it solidify and converted into feces. These feces reaches to the rectum. After receiving the feces from colon, rectum dilate. When the rectum dilate, the urge is creating to defecate the feces through the anus. The process is known as defecation. Removal of feces, the process is known as the defecation. I think the process is very much clear to you all. This is all about in this video. Thank you so much.